Temperatures drop now to minus 14, minus 24 with a wind chill in Ottawa.
810 at Live 88.5.
It's the Friday Morning Thumb on the Live 88.5 Morning Startup.
Louis B. Hobson from Sun Media, not available. Good thing we have Ottawa filmmaker and critic Christopher Redmond in from Dear Cast and Crew. Hello, Chris.
Hey, everyone.
Hey, all right. So a thumbs up or a thumbs down this morning?
Well, I am going to give my hairy, stubby little hobbit thumb down for
The
Hobbit, The Desolation of Smaug. Now, okay. I sort of had a Gollum-like split personality battle about where I was going to land on this film, honestly, when I was leaving it. So let's go through it really quick. So this is hours 12 through 15 in Peter Jackson's Hobbit land, right? Yeah. We've been here before over the past decade. So it's really hard to wow us anymore in a visual sense. In the first films, the Lord of the Rings films, we were just kind of taken over by this spectacle. Well, it's become sort of standard now, so they have to do something to make it new and fresh.
Sure.
For the first Hobbit film that came out last year, what they did was they shot it in 48 frames per second, which had this quality that looked like video. It really looked, everyone was complaining it looked like video. I kind of liked it personally, but this time they haven't done that for the advanced screenings anyway, so this time it just feels like an episode of television. So as you're watching it, there's this sort of impending sense of like, they're not going to resolve this story. I know they're not. They're dragging it out. This is a short children's book that they've dragged into four movies, and so every little detour they're taking, you're saying, I know they're not going to resolve this. I just know.
Yeah.
And so, you're watching this, and it's just kind of an unsatisfying experience in a lot of ways. Now, to give credit where credit's due, for the first time in these 15 hours, a woman is given something to do. So we have a Evangeline Lilly. You know, she actually has a bow and arrow, and she's shooting some things. But really, it's just the story of these merry men of these dwarves. There's about 14 of them, and they seem to be indestructible. They're battling these orcs three times their size. None of them seem to be ever getting hurt. It just feels like there's no consequences to this film, and they're just delaying the inevitable.
Well, how's that different than most movies that have ever been made?
Well, you know, you usually need at least one victim to fall to feel like there's a consequence to what's happening, and it's not just random. There needs to be
kill off somebody.
Yeah, there needs to be some proportion to the carnage that's happening. Otherwise, it's just, you know, it's a little too, I mean, I know it's based on a child's book, but it just feels a little too light, and there's just not enough happening here.
It's a one-sided battle.
Yeah. You know, but again, another part that's interesting is they bring in a dragon, right? So Smaug.
Right.
And this part is actually, it looks great. So once they get to the dragon, it's interesting, it's fun. Apparently they used actual motion capture technology. So there was an actor playing the dragon.
Oh, yeah.
Who would have known? I mean, the dragon's slithering around. There's nothing human-like about it. Again, it's sort of this wasted effort. I think they just wanted to say that they hired this actor to play the dragon. But so overall, you know, if you're a fan of the Lord of the Rings films, the Hobbit films, it's perfectly satisfying.
You're going to see it anyways.
You're going to see it anyways. It's going to be fine. It'll make its $1 billion. Otherwise, it's a bit of a snooze.
Okay, what about a little movie called Sarah Prefers to Run?
Yeah, so here's a film worth checking out. Opens in Ottawa, and this film was actually the only Canadian film to premiere at the Cannes Film Festival this year. Big deal, a big stamp of approval, and the sort of biggest, most prestigious festival in the world. And it's directed by a young Canadian filmmaker. She's only 25. Her name's Chloe Robichaud from Quebec, and it's a story of a small town girl who wants to go to university in Montreal, but can't really afford it. So she has this sort of marriage of convenience with one of her friends because she finds out there's a grant you can get to go to university.
Okay.
But really, she just wants to run, which is where the title comes from. She's a lot like Forrest Gump, you know? I just want to run. And she's got about Forrest Gump's personality in this film as well. Actually, she's got less than Forrest Gump's personality. Forrest Gump's more articulate than she is.
Oh, no!
And which is kind of endearing. You're used to these really kind of smart aleck kids who have everything to say.
Yeah.
This one, you know, she's a typical girl who's just totally lost, and the art direction in the film is beautiful. I think that's why it made the Cannes Film Festival. It's just kind of this gray world, everything, and slowly colors start to emerge as she starts to discover herself and realize there's another thing she likes even more than running, which might be girls, which is an interesting sort of side story of the film. So it's a really nice film.
Okay.
Cool.
There you go. It's a thumbs down for The Hobbit, The Desolation of Smaug. The Friday Morning Thumb with Christopher Redmond. Thanks for coming in this morning. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
It's the Morning Startup, Catfish, Dave, and Amel, and it's 8:15.
Ottawa traffic on Live 88.5.
A pedestrian's been...